use to, without having to use a pencil and all these things. They use the pencil tool and then and the paint bucket, which I'll show. Okay, so pencil, just uniform, and just draw out the shapes that you need, right? I'm recording, so just give me a second. Hold your questions for later. All right, so just that. Don't worry about the, like, they say to draw them with overlap, right? Okay, don't worry too much about the thing. Okay, so anyway, so and I use this guy here. Okay, so you're gonna see at the end why it's okay to draw with the overlap. Okay. Think one line at a time. And there's also this phenomenon with the pencil tool that it makes new lines depending on if it crosses or not. Okay, so I'm just doing this. Actually. Okay. I'm going too fast. Anyway, the theory is, because it's always running out of time. The theory, the I haven't really actually used this too much. So you have this, right? And you change the points to this to give you that kind of doodle look, right? And then you, I think what happens is you expand this. Yes, oops. So expanding appearance. Okay, and then you use the shape builder tool. So the shape builder tool will just now see. Now you can go in and delete the shapes you don't need. Oops. Where the one, like, where there's like extreme overlapping, and then you take all this and then you combine it into one. Okay, so when you take that, if it's a closed system, let's say we just painted with this, right, and we expand, oops. Okay. Right, so like this, let's say expand appearance. Okay. Then mustache tool. Alt minus. Okay. Combine them. Okay, so now with this, you can now go with the paint bucket tool. And fill it with the colors you need. Right. And you continue on from here. Okay. It's pencil. You weren't paying attention. Sorry. Right. So this is the doodle with no pen tooling technique.
I mean, I'm sure I'll master. Like I'll master the
Yeah.
Eventually, but so far,
yeah.
It's just not working.
I know. I've been there. I've been there before. I know that frustration. It does take some practice and time. Mm-hmm. So what would you, how would you now work with something like this, right? So again, so expand, I think expand it. So expand the fill. And then you can ungroup it. Okay. And when you ungroup it, okay, so you keep on grouping it. Now you have all these shapes here. Okay, so knowing that, you have, you can, now it's this normal shape. You can convert it to the draw inside thing. And then you can put a different color, you know, inside of it. Right. We do a pen tool, maybe. Right. As you, as if this is your shadow again, you make that some multiply. Okay, adjust the thing. So if you cut it, click this, make into the draw thing. I think if you paste it in, it becomes a shadow layer. Or you can just paint directly on top of it too. Considering it's the, it's a draw inside layer. So whatever you do on top should work again. Right, so like that. So when you bring it back to expand appearance, so when you bring it back here, it snaps back in. And it looks like you have thing. I mean, this is ready for a t-shirt. You know? It really is. So just, there's a compound path, so just need to release it. Right? And whatnot. Yeah. Okay. So I will save that.